Well, good evening from the Rooster Inn Observatory. I expect this to be a short session because the clouds are all around us. plus, anyway, I plan to swap Dwarf for Seestar 2 as soon as I have a chance tonight. There are two comets that appear side by side in the sky, and I'm gonna try to go for them later tonight. Weather permitting, we also have a bunch of galaxies showing up. I don't know when the needle galaxy will come up. I already imaged it. Trying to find out what I did. I imaged the needle galaxy with the Stellina. Have not imaged it yet with Seestar. I've only had Seestar since October, so needle galaxy may not have been within view. Let me see. When does NGC 4565? Okay, it is rising tonight. So it will be visible here by 9 o'clock, 9 p.m. I will add it to possible targets for Seestar tonight. Needle Galaxy NGC 4565 tonight. Rick, I just captured 30 seconds worth of moon. I will stack these separately. But for now, I'm just enjoying the view of the moon and tracking it. Waiting for the clouds to move in. We can try stacking. Let's see what stacking gives us tonight. So stacking the frames is certainly giving us more fidelity on the craters. Remember, it's still daylight here, so we're not going to get the full benefit of stacking yet. Okay, we're gonna stop the stack, save the image, and go back to tracking the moon live. Go live. See, it doesn't look much different. It's definitely worth trying to refocus now that it's just a bit darker outside. Does it want to focus? So much for autofocus. Okay. It took us to a gain of 80. And a shutter of 1. We don't want that. We certainly do not want infrared pass. Okay, let's go back to video. Gonna have difficulty tracking the moon overhead. Right now the moon is at 70 degrees. Altitude, so it's practically overhead. Let's see what it's going to do tracking wise. I'm going to attempt a refocus. That's good enough. Let it track it. Good evening, RoboCop. How is Sydney today? Is it Sunday already there? Yes, it is. Did you hear the joke about the Indian restaurant on the moon? Good food, no atmosphere. Hot and humid. We don't have this problem here. We had blizzard conditions and zero visibility with blowing snow earlier. I tried to shovel and brush as much snow as I could because it's still windy and I'm trying to avoid blowing snow from covering the lens or at least falling on the lens. For all of you Seestar owners, I discovered that the Rubbermaid 32-gallon plastic the plastic garbage can is a perfect fit for the Seestar, and it protects it from the wind. So I put my Seestar in a garbage can. When it opens, it's looking right above the can, and it can do its imaging normally, but it's protected from the wind. And I put a 20-pound weight at the bottom of the can to prevent it from moving. Good evening, Alan. I'll give you a link momentarily. Yeah, DWARF does a very, very nice job with the moon. The seeing is not too good tonight. Clouds, snow, everything imaginable. But that's a reasonably good picture. Let me see if I can... this is the best we're gonna get tonight. It's very focused, but the seeing is not good. Let's see if Dwarf is going to calibrate properly tonight. All right, this is a good start. Oh, come on. Okay, calibration success despite problems. Let's go to there we go. Something not happy. We're going to look for stacked, the full 4K, okay. Gain 80, shutter 10, infrared cut. Dwarfy is not happy tonight. Okay, there we go. The stars are very elongated for some reason. Let's see what it'll do. This is much better. This is more like it. I have noticed with the latest firmware upgrade that stacking is taking longer, and that the two functions of capture and stacking are running in parallel and totally independently. So the sensor captures images and just throws them in a bucket, and then the processor picks them up from the bucket and stacks them. So the current and the stacked are running independently, with the only requirement that stacked will always be smaller than current. I tried running 1 second captures and the current ran up all the way to 40 or so, was stacked still catching up at around 5 or 6. This is the weather map right now. I am the dark blue spot in the middle, right here. And this is all snow around us. And it is fairly widespread lake effect snow. And this is the primary reason why I have the dwarf outside and not the sea star. Dwarf is a little bit more water resistant than the other scopes. With a bit of luck, the wind will not shift on us and the snow will remain, about 10 miles north of us. And with it, the clouds will stay out of the way. Okay, enough snow, let's go back to the sky. Thank you. We have a few satellite trails up there. I'm going to give DWARF a few more minutes on M44. Don't expect much change. And then I'd like to hop onto M96, Messier 96. What DWARF could do for that target if it picks it up is show M96, M95, and M105 all in the same field of view. They are a little bit low right now, so we'll see if they've cleared the trees yet. Otherwise, we'll come back to them. If M96 does not work out, we'll come back to M67. Messier 67 is up high. No, I can still set all these things. Let me show you. So I'm going to go live. And I'm going to find M67. Star target, call, find M67, confirm. Okay. It says it found it, and this is where I can do all the settings. Under settings, I can determine the number, stacked or single, binning. And then here, under exposure, I can set infrared pass or cut. I can set the gain. I can set the shutter speed, 10 in this case. And then I can go to tone, and here, I can set the white balance. I can set the brightness, the contrast, the hue. So I still have those controls available to me. Let's get capturing M67. Okay, I shall try that. Are they grayed out only for astro? Because I have been able to set them earlier this evening for the moon. Okay, I'll try them next target. Yeah, I had not seen the need to tinker with white balance for astro targets. I am very pleased right now with how round the stars are. Despite the wind outside. I purchased recently a USB-C power adapter, 100 watt, plugs in the wall, 110 or 120, and plugs into Seestar or DWARF, and can run all night without any problem, regardless of weather. And I only paid $17 for it. I'm going to post the link in case somebody is interested. But that is a very inexpensive way to provide a power supply if you have access to electricity. It certainly beats having to carry multiple batteries. I have not tried replacing the battery on the Seestar. It does not look easy. I have an extra battery on DWARF. Well, I ended up buying two. I'm using one of them to power my laptop through the USB-C and saving the second one to power the scopes. I like a lot the fact that the wire coming out of the adapter is a solid USB connector, so I don't have to go through additional wires that plug into USB on one side and plug into the telescope on the other. And I don't have to worry about the rating of the cables. I know that this one will give me lots of amps, and it does. It is rating for 100 watts, and it is delivering 100 watts to my Dell laptop. Dell requires a lot of current, the Vostro, when it's running at full processing, and this adapter supplies the power without any problem. Okay, I'm gonna attempt and see where M96 is now, if we can catch it yet. It is at about 13 degrees. So let's see if that's gonna work. And I will check the brightness, see if we can control it to just verify that it is indeed grayed out. All right, let's go live. We're gonna stop tracking. You are correct. These are all grayed out. So everything undertone is grayed out. Exposure, okay, these work still. Let me just double check that under video mode, yeah, okay. These are available under video mode, but not under astro mode. Okay. Learned something new tonight. Astro. Star target. M96. If we do it right, M96 will give us M95, M96, and M105 all in the same field of view, thanks to DWARF's 3-degree field of view. Go to success. Now these are all galaxies, so I don't need to turn on infrared. So it is, we're gonna cut. I'm gonna adjust shutter to 10. Let's see what that gives us. You're welcome. Thanks for pointing it out. Bright and early tomorrow morning at around 4 a.m. My time. Comet Charlie 2021 Sierra 3 and Comet 125 Papa are going to be very, very close to each other. The big challenge is going to be that Comet 125P is magnitude 17. That'll be something for more so Stellina than anything else. But we'll see. And earlier tonight, in about 45 minutes, asteroid Juno and asteroid Bamberg is going to be within a fraction of a degree from each other. And that's something I might attempt with DWARF. I've never captured asteroids or the dwarf, but that should be a good test. Juno right now is at is 2 degrees up altitude due east. So we're gonna have to wait another hour at least. 7:30, call it 8:30. We're gonna attempt to image two asteroids at the same time. At 8:30, altitude will be 10 degrees, but it'll be due east. And I have an open sky to the east. Magnitude of Juno is 8.8. And magnitude of Bamberga is 12. 12 is pushing it for dwarf, but we'll see. We're supposed to have three galaxies here. I can see them, but they're extremely faint. Something not right. We have only stacked 8 out of 24. Let me take a peek outside, see if it's snowing. There will be no asteroids tonight. Our luck has run out. The sky is covered with clouds. And according to the radar, the snow is right behind the clouds. So I'm gonna wish you all a good night, a happy Sunday for those who are already on Sunday. And if the weather clears again, or when the weather clears again, we will be sure to let you know and to join you. So we lucked out. We had 2 hours, just under 2 hours of clear skies. And not much more I can hope for these days. So long from the Rooster Inn Observatory, and I wish you the best.